Perfect. Yeah. So I'm the lab manager at the Boss Institute. So I'm, running around with everybody. And some one of the many projects that we have here is this fly study in neurobiology led by Jeannie. And that was my introduction for Jeannie.
Jeannie, tell us about what you do.
Hi, I'm currently a research associate at Boz. I'm currently looking at the sex differences between female and male fruit flies, and specifically on how their brains are changed based off of stress.
That is amazing. It's completely intriguing to me. I think about the genome of that when we were talking to somebody else about that. But flies are oviparous, right? How long is a fruit fly's life cycle? Because it must be pretty short if you guys are studying it, right?
Initially, when I was studying fruit flies, I thought it would be pretty short too. But my fruit flies actually live between 60 to 80 days, surprisingly. So, 2 to 3 months.
Wow, so there's like, I used to be told a lot, oh, just let it live. You don't, the fly with the fly swatter, it'll be gone in 24 hours. That's totally not true, right?
You will have a fly
You'll
problem.
have a fly for a while and they'll lay a lot of oviparous eggs.
Yeah,
Right?
one female can actually lay about 500 eggs. So even if you just have one, it'll create an issue in your home, I'm sure.
That's a lot of eggs. That is a tremendous amount of eggs. So what are you looking for at the end of your research? Do you have a goal in mind, looking at these?
Well, we want to just study more on how female and males differ when it comes to reacting to stress. So, for some genes, maybe they'll be expressed more than others. Maybe their mechanisms of stress are different, and we want to identify which ones those are.
That's incredible. Oh, Christine, hi. Can you hear us?
Christine went away again. My apologies.
Oh, it's all good. So I'm really interested in the flies. Like I was telling them, is that they have the same life cycle like butterflies because they go through. So they're a caterpillar, and then they go into their chrysalis, and then they come out as a butterfly with wings. I think that is really amazing. It's something that we lose sight on. I use them as food for my geckos. Unfortunately, to use them for science, I kind of use them for science too, a little bit, right? Right?
Yeah, definitely.
And they stay longer in the pupa state if they're cold, right?
Yeah, you can definitely control them. If you want to make them speed up a little more, you turn up the heat. If you want them slow down a little bit, you make them, chill and relax with lower temperatures.
So I keep mine in the fridge, which is why I ended up getting my own personal fridge outside. Because they're like, you cannot have those in the fridge at all. We're really excited about your guys' science. It sounds like something that if you guys are looking into exploring and discovering and being curious at the Boz Institute, they're looking into some amazing things about how your brain works, how our brains work, by discovering the life cycle, the genetics, the gender of fruit flies, and how they interact. Is that correct?
Yeah, definitely. That's one of the many parts, and there's many more projects in the lab that we're also using the same similar ideas to explore these differences, at the genetic level, molecular level. And flies are one of the great models we have. I mean, if you're more interested, you can always visit us online, bozinstitute.org. We got programs for, high school students to really like see how it is in person. Well, eventually when things, settle down with coronavirus, but we have virtual classes too to, explore all these different things as well.
Absolutely. So you guys go check out the Boz Institute. There's tons of opportunities for high school students if you guys want to check it out. And you're talking about oviparous. So flies, what did you say? Like 500 eggs? That's super cool. Other people think it's freaky.